It's Friday. It's Anthony, and it's early. So this week's about workouts and all that stuff. I'm actually about to get ready to go to the gym now. So I guess I'll start off with how much I work out, why I work out, give you a little bit of my workout, what I do, supplements I use and all that stuff. So it's been 2 years since I started testosterone, and I was very unmotivated for a really long time. I don't know what it was, but I couldn't find the will to like pick up and go to the gym consistently. I struggled up until January of this year. And during all of that time, I kind of gained weight. I gained 10 pounds since starting testosterone, and it's not cool. So, what happened? Oh, January came around, and I'm not really sure what happened, but as soon as January hit, I kind of just made it a thing. Like, that's my thing now. I go to the gym every day before work, on my off days. Maybe I'll go to the gym, but it's usually my rest day. On the weekends, I don't go. So 5 out of 7 days, I'm in the gym for about 2 hours. And if I don't, I get really depressed and I feel like my life sucks. Before, I was like trying to be consistent about it, and it was looking back now, it's kind of hilarious, but I would like go to the gym, not know what the fuck I'm doing, and then be there for like 3 hours and like playing with my asshole, and then I would become unmotivated the next day and then stay out of the gym for like 3 or 4 weeks and excuse me, go back and do it again and all this bullshit. And then I finally realized the gym was not for me, and I gave up my Planet Fitness membership. Then I got Blink, and I don't even know where Blink is in the world, but I know they're in New York, and they're all right. It could be better, but it's a pretty chill gym. It's also cheap, so I'm not balling, so it's cool that I have a cheap gym to go to. I go to Blink. There's a couple of locations in the city, but Bryant Park is close to me, so I go there. My job actually offers a New York Sports Club membership after 3 months of working. So, I'm about to try New York Sports Club. See what that's like. Because I need a better gym. As far as like workouts go, I'm usually, right now I'm on a 12-week plan. And I'm on week 3 right now. And with this plan, you kind of start off easy, high reps, low weight, and you kind of just pick up as the weeks go by. So I'm at like a moderate weight right now doing mid reps. It seems to be showing a little bit more that I'm actually working out, which is cool. And this has been like consistent, I don't know, what is it, 5 months since January? 4 months? Three? Four. Four. So yeah, 4 months, and I'm seeing a little bit of a difference, which is great.
Sorry. I am so fucking tired.
Jesus. But yeah, so today's actually my leg day and my ab day, and I know a lot of people hate leg day. I don't fucking mind it. It's pretty cool. Can lift about 3 times my weight, which is cool. I guess I'll post a picture of like some of the workouts that I will video. Sorry, some of the workouts that I do. Because I kind of really don't want to get into my whole workout plan. I'll be talking here for like 12 years. But after this 12 weeks, I'm gonna go into another program for shredding. Right now I'm picking up muscle and like building size. But yeah, so supplements. I am like the king of fucking supplements. Trying them out, hating them, spending all my money. I love GNC. I don't know why. Bodybuilding.com is so cheap, but I'm so impatient. So GNC, I'm in there like every fucking day buying all this bullshit I have no business buying. I don't even fucking use. Like, I've got this whole counter of supplements. I've got a lot of shit, and I'm actually looking for somebody to give it to. If anybody wants it, take it. I've probably at most taken like a scoop from it. But yeah, if I don't like something, I can't use it, cause like I just can't. It just doesn't work. So I've tried so many brands. I've tried Cellucor pre-workout. I don't like it. It makes me feel like Edward Cullen, like I'm fucking tingling and sparkling. It also brings me up and down really bad. I don't really care for that. What else have I tried? I've tried I think it's called like ISO 100, their whey protein. It's really, really sweet. And it's also got aspartame in it, which is really bad for you. And that's what they put in like diet stuff and stuff with like less sugar or whatever. The additive is usually aspartame to make it sweet, and it's really, really, really bad for you. Don't drink diet shit. If you want to drink diet shit, drink fucking water, and that's it. What else have I tried? I've tried GNC's brand, like isolate protein. And that tastes like shit too, and it's also got aspartame in it because it's like sugar free or whatever the fuck. Sucks. I tried GNC's creatine chews, and I just don't feel like you absorb much when you're chewing on something as opposed to like actually downing it. It's kind of like those gummy vitamins. Your body doesn't absorb those at all. Stop buying them, stop eating them, stop using them. What else? I had I had Insanity, the Shanti's Insanity, and they kind of jipped me and made me pay for all of this protein shit that they have and like this pre-workout shit that they have, and it's fucking terrible. They just kept sending it to me, and I'm like, why is my card being charged for all this shit? They had no answer. But yeah, fucking terrible. It sucks. The program's not bad. I can't do it. I don't have the space, the time,
and the motivation
to stand in my fucking living room and do cardio. I have to be in the gym. That's the only way I'll be able to do it. What else have I tried? Arnold Schwarzenegger has like a fucking brand of shit. And I tried his multivitamins. Just because I felt like I needed multivitamins because I lack a lot of things. But I can't really swallow 11 pills every day and like remember to do so. It just doesn't work out for me. Amino acids. Amino acids are really good for you, but they usually come in fucking horse pills, and it scrapes my throat. So, I stopped taking them. However, with all of this, and Cellucor's whey protein. It doesn't taste terrible, I'm not gonna lie. I just don't like the taste of whey protein. I am lactose intolerant, and whey protein is a dairy-based product. It's made from animal bones. Hate to tell you, it sounds gross, but you take it. But yeah, it's made from animal bones, and it's, it doesn't sit well with my stomach. But they've got this cinnamon swirl flavor. It's actually really good. However, in my job, we use plant protein, and plant protein is actually not bad at all. It's really good, easier to digest. The only thing is really expensive. But if you're looking for a whey alternative, go for plant. It will be easier on your stomach. But yeah, so out of all of those items, the three that I consistently use and like don't stop using and spend all my fucking money on, and I need to go spend my money on today because they're empty, are Performix brand pre-workout and the BCAAs and concrete creatine HCI, the microdosing. So I buy it unflavored, and this comes with 64 servings. It's actually a really small scoop. So I don't know if you can see, but it's a tiny ass scoop, and it's just this white powder. I don't really want to tip it over, and whatever. It's just white powder, and it says unflavored, but it's got a fucking flavor. And if you drink it with anything other than the pre-workout, you're gonna like, it's just terrible. It's very bitter. So I use that. I feel like this kind of gives me more of a pump added on to the pump that my pre-workout gives me. Yeah, I can also kind of like dose it myself, as I feel like if I have more tolerance, I can take more, whatever. And I'm not bouncing off the fucking walls trying to kill myself. Yeah, I don't know. Like, it's really cool. It also helps your body recover a lot faster. Your body recovers when you're sleeping. Which is why if you're working out and you're expecting to do or lose or gain or whatever, you need to sleep a significant amount at night, so your body can recover completely for the next day. And then Performix, I use this. This is my pre-workout. This is the best pre-workout that I've had ever in life. It tastes really good. This one's watermelon. I don't really care for the watermelon flavor, but the tangerine is fucking bomb. Tastes really good. It's got these little beads in it. I didn't buy it for the beads. I just bought it because I'm tired of shit tasting terrible. And it also doesn't make you like tingle and all that shit. Like, it's pretty decent. It's also got a bunch of really cool benefits and shit. It's not that expensive. It's $30 for 20 servings. It's kind of funny because the box is like this big, but the amount that you get is about this big. But whatever. Then I use the Performix ISO BCAAs. These aren't bad either. This is Punch Berry Ice. It's the only flavor that I've tried. I'm probably gonna buy another one. But yeah, I take these BCAAs. So these three things are the only things that I'll take. I use these two together. And then the BCAAs are after. And then I usually, like, at work, if I'm hungry before work starts or whatever, I'll grab a protein bar. I like the Combat Bars and the Fit Elite, or the Fit Crunch by Robert Irving. Really good. Doesn't taste like protein. I fucking hate the taste of protein. They don't taste like protein. It's really good. Really good stuff. But yeah, that's just about it. That's my workout. Stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna post a couple of videos and like photos, I guess, before and after, and see if I like have gained weight, lose weight, whatever. Oh, I actually lost 10 pounds. So the 10 pounds that I gained, I lost. It's great, really great, fucking great. So yeah, I'll see you guys next week. Have a great week and all that.